Hello everybody and welcome back to Stardew Valley, where today we will definitely 100% we'll be getting sorted. We'll get that salmonella to Alex today. Oh, hello adventurer man. Bumped into Robin this morning. She told me you got a new slime hutch. Not bad. I was into slime breeding at your age. It's a great hobby, but dangerous. How do you think I lost this eye? To a slime. Just kidding. Here, I've got something for you. You received a green slime egg. It's a slime egg. You can place that inside a slime incubator to hatch it. Now take a good hard look at that egg. Next time you're out slime hunting, keep your eyes peeled for more eggs. They're rare, but slimes do drop them from time to time. Collect eggs from different slimes to add some variety to your herd. Wow. So cool. Ah, hello friend. The mountain lake has been kind to me lately. I'd like to share my good fortune with you. Linus, I love when Linus gives me a gift because he has nothing and he still shares stuff with me and it's so cute. Hello dear, I know you're just getting started as a gardener, so I wanted to give you a little tip. Seriously, Evelyn. Most crops only grow in one season. When summer arrives, your spring crops will all die out, so plan ahead, Granny Evelyn. Just starting out in year three. I know everything about this game now. Let's go have a look at this slime hutch. Wow, look how cool that is. I still need to move it back one. I wanted it back a little longer. I can't do anything with the shrine anymore. But there was a chicken in the way. So let's go have a look. So we have a slime hutch here. And we have... I guess those must be the slime incubators. So this is my slime here. Put them in there. Oh no. No, that would be the incubator at the back. I must need to feed them something there. There we go. I think it's going to be possibly, as he said, quite a dangerous hobby. I'm not sure if these guys come out in the rain. No, they don't. Oh, bless them. They must not like getting wet. Oh well, they can stay on for one more day. And we're going to just have a quick look at the animals, see how they're doing. If they hate me. I love that they still like me a little bit. Pigs hate me. The pigs really hate me. This is why I'm getting no truffles. I'm not feeding them. I'm not doing anything to help them at all at the moment. It's really bad. Okay. Well, at least you kind of know I love you. Rainy day's a good day to go and check in on everyone. Oh, good grief. Look at all these eggs everywhere. I need to be better at this, don't I? Too busy gallivanting around. At least the ducks got fed. I think the game maybe should have been a bit more even with its feeding, but never mind. We'll go and see Marnie and we'll get a whole bunch of hay. We'll go say hi to the chickens as well. We'll go and put all the stuff in the shed on the way past though. And then we'll go see Marnie. And Robin to get stone. And the wizard. We actually don't even... Oh, I was going to say, I said I was going to go in the shed and I never did. Pick up all these eggs. Say hi to all the chickens that hate me. Maybe don't like their door being open in the wet. Well, we'll have to see about that. Apparently when I ignore them, they don't like it. I promise I will be a better farmer once everybody loves me and I'm married and I've nothing better to do. I'll be an awesome farmer then. Be so good. Right, Clawthuck, we got some stuff to do. First, we need to put the stuff away in the shed. Then, we need to go see Alex. Then, we need to go see Robin. Then, oh, Apricot. Okay, we'll sort that out on another day, I think. No, we do not want to eat the duck egg. Oh, typical, everything is done. I do not want to eat it. Really need to work on all this. It's just my life, story of my life, full of things I need to do that I haven't quite managed yet. Oh, diamond. Yay, yummy. Oh, I could do putting some starfruit in the kegs, to be honest. No, I'm going to leave it until I've done the Junimo hut, otherwise I'll end up not doing it. Okay, so I've got room in my inventory now. I'm just going to keep it like that, that's fine. I'm going to see Alex, I'm going to give him a salmon dinner if it kills me. Then maybe I'll see Robin first, actually. Because Marnie and the wizard are on the way to each other, so that would make more sense. Luckily, when it's raining out, everyone stays inside. Hello, Alex. Would you like this salmon dinner that I specially prepared for you like 3 days ago? I totally froze it, so it's good. Hey, awesome. I love this stuff. 9 out of 10. This is not good weather for sports. Oh well, I can always lift weights inside. Okay, cool. Right, probably one more really nice thing for him and he'll be like totally mine. Good. So how are we doing with Elliot? He's on 8 hearts, so a few more pomegranates and he'll be mine as well. Cool. So next, Robin's house. We need 200 stone. Then we need to drop back by the farm to get the 100 fiber. I really hope we have 100 fiber. If not, we might have to go to the sewers to get it. Because I think that bug island, you can get fiber up there. Okay. We're at Robin's. Hi, Robin. May I have 200 stone, please? Thank you very much. Quick, quick, quick. I'm not going to have enough money at the end of this, possibly, to actually buy the thing. No, I don't now. No! I have to sell like 400's worth of stuff. Right, okay, we need stuff to sell. We could sell to Pierre, maybe. Let's go this way. Back to the farm. Sell stuff to Pierre. Like strawberries or something, like 400's worth of that. I could maybe even sell him all my jam, actually. So, we need to find where we put all the fiber. I don't know where it is. Race against time. Okay, that's all the fibre. I've got the stone, I've got the fibre. I've got the starfruit. Stone, fibre, starfruit, money. Okay. 63 gold star strawberries. Going to Pierre right now. Then we will get our Junimo hut number 2. See, by the time you've got all the sprinklers and the Junimo huts and everything like that, you've got no space for actual crops anymore. But we did well with the strawberries, so let's see if he'll buy them. 11,000? That's not bad. At all. You can have those blueberries too. Can't have my starfruit though. It's worth too much. It's actually the price of the starfruit alone adds a significant value to those Junimo huts. I should have a look while I'm down at the wizards at like how much other stuff he's got. So if we go to Marnie first, because she'll shut first, and then we'll go to the wizard. I have to hope no weeds have grown in that spot. Oh! What are you doing, Shane? Shelob. I'm sorry. Hick. Those are all beer bottles, Shane. What have you done? My life. It's a pathetic joke. Look at me. Why do I even try sobbing? I'm always crying and everything. I'm too small and stupid to take control of my life. I'm just a piece of soiled garbage flitting in the wind. Yeah. Sorry, I'm totally taking away from the seriousness of this by doing burping noises. But that's what it said. I've been coming here often lately, looking down. Here's a chance to finally take control of my life, these cliffs. That's not taking control of your life, Shane. But I'm too scared, too anxious, just like always. Oh, Shane, no. Shelab, all I do is work, sleep, and drink. I can understand that apart from the drinking, but it's too dull, the feelings of self-hatred. Why should I even go on? Tell me. Tell me why I shouldn't roll off this cliff right now. Oh, Shane, don't roll off the cliff. Jas needs you. You're like a father to her. There's so much to live for. No, I'm going to say Jas needs you. You're right. Jas. Oh, God, I'm horrible. Selfish person. Now I feel even worse. But you're not going to jump off the cliff, so... Shelab. I think you should take me to the hospital now. I think I should too. Oh, Shane, seriously. I've pumped his stomach and rehydrated his body. He's gonna be okay. It's good that you brought him in, though. Too much alcohol is terrible for the body, but right now I'm most worried about his mental health. When he comes to, I'll have a chat with him about his treatment options. I know an excellent counselor in Zuzu City. Oh, poor Shane. Life can be painful sometimes. But there's always hope for a better future. You've got to believe in that. What was I doing? The cutscenes can sometimes really throw you. I've lost Korthok as well. I think he was back here somewhere. Probably lost him at the... Oh my goodness, cutscene! Shelab! You caught me! Spying on Emily, are you? I was planning to ask Emily on a date. I was at her doorstep and everything, but then I heard her coming and I dove into this bush. Now I'm waiting until she's done talking with Caroline so I can sneak back into my house. Just talk to her! So annoying. What did you just say? You'll never upgrade your tools again if I don't ask her out. I don't upgrade them anyway. You're a villain, Shelab. Alright, I'll do it. I gotta remember that advice Shelab gave me in the saloon. I don't remember what I said. Emily? Sorry, Caroline, could you excuse me for a minute? Ah, good friend, Caroline. Totally still listening. Yes, Clint? I was wondering if you go with tomorrow me. Don't run away. I've got 2 tickets for the Grampleton Carnival tomorrow. Would you go with me? Sure, Clint. That sounds fun. Really? Okay, I'll pick you up at 5. Okay, see you tomorrow. Clint, you're my hero! You asked her out! Yes! Did you see that? I've got a date tomorrow night. Oh man, I'm so nervous. Oh, so good. I love that, that's awesome. Right, now, the chickens really need feeding now. Oh, those are good cutscenes. It was a really sad cutscene with Shane, though. I hope he gets better. Hi, supplies heal up. I really need supplies. Lots of supplies. But I need to make sure I don't go under 20,000 with it. Maybe a couple of hundred. Okay. I should have a look at what else a wizard does. I've forgotten what else he actually does. My terrible memory. Oop, I'm gonna get stuck if we go that way. I never understand why there's weird burping sounds when it rains. That's confused me for the months I have been playing this game. Right, so. I have all the stuff. Build me a Junimo hut, please. Please put it here. Actually, do I need it there, maybe? Well, it's only one level it's doing. Yeah, there should be fine. I can move it if I need to. Okay, so let's have a look at what else there is in this place. So, an earth obelisk that warps you to the mountains. Water obelisk. Preventing decay and the Junimo hut. Oh right, there wasn't actually that much there then. Warping me to the beach and warping me to the mountains doesn't really bother me that much. Would maybe be handy. Like a permanent warp totem effectively. So those might be handy to go for if I've got like stupid amounts of money. I'd probably want to go for the thing that warps me home first. And then hope I don't, like, lose it going down the mines or something. Because it's one of these things that you would really want going down the mines, but then you wouldn't really want to lose it going down the mines either. Okay, right, now I think I need to put the hay into the silo just to make sure the auto feeders work. And then I can start doing things with... I could probably harvest all those strawberries as well. Just because the Junimos are not doing their job today. Because it's raining. Definitely getting a lot more of them now. It's gotten to the second half of the year. But because it took me so long to get started with them. I do need, I think for if I was going to do strawberries in year 4, I would need to just keep a lot of strawberry seeds. So I might keep a big stack of strawberries by anyway. It was quite handy selling that big stack of them though. Because it's nice where you can buy the seeds for things off Pierre. I don't know, maybe he does sell strawberry seeds. I didn't see them though. I didn't see them, so. See if there's any actually in the Junimo hut itself as well. Yeah, there's a few. 35 gold star, 16 silver star, and 6 normal. And we can give Emily her apricot as well. Not that it'll do much, other than just give me the quest reward. I'll put these away in the chest, and I'll find something else to put in. Yeah, I could make cranberry stuff. Cranberry jelly. That'll do me. And we'll get some eggs in the mayo machine. Nice large eggs. Do need to make more of these mayo machines, of the cheesemakers, of everything really. Some milk for the cheesemaker. We're running out of milk and the amount of cheese that I'm making is pathetic, so the fact I'm running out of milk just shows that I'm being very poor keeper to my cows. I'm also trying to put milk in a mayonnaise maker. It's not going to work. We have leftover star fruits, so I'll stick them in the wine keg. Hopefully we'll get some more ancient fruits, and then we'll start putting them in wine kegs as well. And then we'll be filthy rich. Okay, that's all done. I think we'll still catch Elliot. Possibly not. I'll maybe just make sure that the chickens and the cows and stuff are okay, because I've been really mean to them lately. I haven't done much to help them out. You want your door shut, maybe. It's raining. Maybe I spoke to them earlier. I don't remember. They're looking a little thin. So now I've given them more food, they should be a little bit happier at least. Okay, let's go and see the cows. We'll maybe milk them. And shear the sheep and stuff. I've got all the stuff in my inventory for doing that, so I obviously meant to. Hello. Oh, you're trying to sleep. Okay, well, we'll just milk the cows then, because I think we can do that while they're sleeping. I think. Come on. There we go. I think they may be struggling because there's not enough food, but they will have food in the morning, which will be good. And we trimmed our sheep. Okay, well, that's a little bit of animal maintenance done for once. We've got the two journeyman huts built now, which is fantastic. I'll go and check on our slime as well. I doubt much will have happened in there because it's only been built since this morning. Yeah, it's fine. I need to get more sprinklers done to finish this section off. Grass is growing back quite nicely over there. Need to plant some more flowers down here, make more bee houses. Oh, so much to do. So much to do. That shouldn't be there. What? I think I just tried to milk a piece of grass. No one saw that, right? I should really have a look at achievements as well, see what I need to do for that. I could plant more strawberries, but we're like halfway through now. We've only got like 10 days and they take about 7 days to grow, so I don't know how much we're going to get off that anyway. So I'd be better off just working on trying to get sprinklers for the next season and trying to get everything done for that. I'm going to need quite a few more. See if we... Let's go and just like sort our inventory out as well, because that'll be good for the next day. Nothing else. I've got like bits of milk and bits of star fruit and all sorts. Should be in my chest, really. Oh no, all those have finished. Okay, so cranberries, strawberries, possibly even horseradish and stuff like that should be in here. The fiber can stay in there. All my plant stuff basically can go in there. All my milk can go in there. Oh no, I don't have room for it all. I've got starred eggs, that's why. I'll stick them in the mayonnaise maker, maybe. I have no idea why they're starred. 35 energy, 14 health. I have no idea. I didn't realise that the eggs could get stars on them, or the milk, but that's going to cause horrendous problems with keeping things in this chest. But we've got all sorts of stuff we shouldn't have in this chest, to be honest. Kale, amaranth, pine tar. What's that in there for, like? Honestly, it should be just for eggs and cloth and things like that. Now I have a full inventory. Okay, well, we could put kale in the juicy fruit chest. That would probably just go in there, and the amaranth. The diamond can go up in here. I need a chest for all the like pine tars and stuff like that I'm getting. Oh, so bad. So much stuff I need to put in chests and keep organized, and I'm really not very organized at all. Stone floors, Mackey rolls. Too much stuff. Should have a little, like, cooked food chest. Ooh, is that a starfruit wine? Oh, it's a blueberry wine. That's rubbish. I'll put starfruit in there. Okay, I think it's probably just time for bed now, honestly. I'll see if I can put anything in the chests over here. These are more like my junk chests, honestly. They are for junk and rubbish and stuff that I don't want to sell. Like pizza, and pine tar, and oak resin. And I'll sell a few things so we can make some money, because look how poor we are. I don't even look at money anymore, to be honest. Okay, we'll go to bed now. And I will try my best to be more industrious in future. But it probably won't happen, because I'll go around socialising. But I just get the impression that if you can either be really social or you can make tons of money. But then if you make tons of money, you can give everyone presents and then be super social that way, so... I don't know. But we'll do one social thing in the morning, and that will be to go and see Elliot. I'm assuming... because I normally do 2 days, I've completely lost track of whether I did 1 or 2 days here. So the Egg Festival and Haley's birthday, the 15th, and now we're on the 16th. Yes, so this is one more day to do. We had a very long... we're going to have a long episode, and... oh, it's because... cutscenes. Got another one now. Okay, Shane says, hey. Oh man, how do I say this? I'm really sorry about what happened at the cliffs. That was embarrassing. I'm glad I was there to help, I'm gonna say. Yeah, me too. I've decided I want to see a therapist. Harvey got me in touch with a colleague of his. Anyway, I just wanted to thank you for taking care of me, and I want you to know that I'm going to take things a little more seriously from now on. I think that was taking things seriously, but maybe a little too seriously. I don't want to be a burden on anyone. You're not a burden. Oh, Shane. What am I going to do with you? I just noticed that there. Now I have a letter as well. Dear Shelab, you're such a good neighbour. I thought I'd send over some animal feed to make your job easier. Keep it up, Marnie. Could have done with that a couple of days ago, to be honest, Marnie. Before I bought like 200 off you. Or is that like a freebie for getting for being a good customer? You're such a good customer. You get like extra 30 pieces. There you go. It'll keep everyone fed for like a day, that man. Go check if our ancient fruit has given us any more fruit. No. Probably takes a long time to make any fruit out of that at all. Let's see if our slime hutch has done anything. Still incubating. It'll probably come and attack me when I try and do anything. Alright, now let's just go and see how much... so, for sprinklers. The sprinklers we need not to be in the map. The crafting menu. For the sprinklers, we need 1 iron, 1 gold, 1 quartz. Let's go see how much we've got of that, because we need a lot of sprinklers. People keep saying I could make an iridium sprinkler, but I'd have to redesign the whole layout of my farm, so what I want to do is get enough iridium together to make quite a few, and then between seasons just go and sort things out. So I can make another 2 if I have some more gold. I do have gold, but I don't have coal, so what I think we need to do is take this wood and make some coal. Oh, I do have coal, actually, it's in my inventory. That was nearly bad. So I make a few bits of gold, and then we'll come and get them and make a couple of sprinklers out of it. We could make some more iron and some more iridium. No, not iridium, some more refined quartz. Got enough stuff to do that. I think that would be quite handy. So that the 5 bars of gold we've got will turn into 5 sprinklers. But we'll have to do that in a couple of batches. So we'll put that away. And we'll put the wood back away. Sunflower seeds I've got as well. Don't even need those. These eggs. Let me just put these eggs away. And this milk into the cheesemaker as well. So we can... have some nice mayonnaise. Get rid of these, because they don't stack. Something made a weird sound as if it had just finished, but I don't think it has. Truffle. Have we got any truffles? No. Let's see if there's any in the chest. Make some more truffle oil. Couple there. We are kind of running out. I need to pay more attention to the animals. So on that note, I'm going to go and check them out and just make sure they're okay. Those away. I can't wait for the coffee to grow. I think coffee is one... Do you know what I need to do? Is to plant that coffee bean in my greenhouse and start making coffee bean plants, because then I will be able to avoid the situation that I had with the strawberries this year. So we are going to plant my golden coffee bean right here. Oh, it's right at the end there. And it might be a trellis crop, but I'll just keep harvesting it manually. And then I'll be able to fill this with coffee, if coffee is something that I can do. If not, it'll be something like, I think it's green beans in the spring and like hops in the summer or something like that. And we may as well go and see Emily and give her her fresh fruit. She might be in the bar later, actually. I could go see her then, couldn't I? Let's go see the chickens. Hopefully they will be happy this morning. Still raining, so I'm still going to keep their wee door closed. They haven't made much in the way of stuff like eggs and wool, but to be expected, they are not very happy at the moment. Metasapia still likes me. Cool. This shows how old this playthrough is. I've still got a chicken called Metasapia, and she's been meta asleep for months now. Some of them don't even like me one heart anymore. I'm sorry, animals. I'm so sorry. I promise I will milk you and brush you and come and see you every day. I think Keeper has probably like run away at this point. She's probably in the house. Might even be in the walls again, like he was the other day. That was a bit crazy. Crazy, crazy Keeper. I'm going to shut this door as well. And shut the door on the duck pen. Because then I don't think they like the wet weather. Or at least that's what everyone tells me. Because they've got food, look, and they're still really unhappy. So it's like, yeah. You're not happy with me for leaving your door open. Okay, we're starting again with the pigs, basically. Can't do an awful lot. At least they have food now, which is really good. So I can milk the cows, so that'll get them back to liking me. Or maybe not. Maybe the cows only get milked every 2 days now. We'll try the goats. I have no milk, that's fine. So it's not saying that they had no milk, so it was just the wrong angle, I think. So one of the goats should have milk. Oh no, apparently they don't. Okay. That's all I can do here. I did shear Kathy yesterday, so we'll see if she can be sheared again. Apparently she can. Oh, I thought I had sheared her, but I don't think I did it right, because that certainly didn't happen like that yesterday. We'll go see the ducks as well. They've laid me quite a lot of eggs, actually. On all the ducks. I'm not going to even check how much they love me, because it's probably nothing. They love me nothing. I did not go and see them all winter, and now they love me nothing. Right, and then the other thing I'm going to do, because I can go and get bait now, right? That's something I might just go and do quickly. Let's pick up these. I'm going to go put them at the beach. so I can see if I can catch a lobster. These Junimos, they are shirking their work. I'm not supposed to be having to do this for them. Stupid Junimos that don't work in the rain, I don't know. Oh, yeah, before we go to the beach, we should see if we can find the pomegranates. Which I've no doubt put somewhere stupid. Oh, I do have bug meat. Okay, well, we'll take that as well so we can make some bait. I thought I did because we've been down to the that area. Take the iridium ore. 4 a day is pretty good. I actually have a lot of iridium ore. I just don't have the things to make the sprinklers with, unfortunately. So I must have put the pomegranates in here somewhere. Oh, good grief. Okay, I'm going to ignore that just for now. I'll come back. Otherwise I'll miss people. Like, I can do all of this later on. Get my sprinklers going and all that. The ideal will be to get that going in time for summer. Maybe have a summer wedding. But who too? Stay tuned to find out. I'm leaning towards Shane a lot at the moment because he's got such a sad story. I want to see how he pulls himself together. I think with Shane, I am catching, because he's been put in as a single recently, and I already had quite a lot of hearts with him, so I seem to be catching up on a lot of his cutscenes. They're like kind of happening slowly. Hello, Mr. Elliot. How are you doing today? The sweet friction of pen and paper is the music of my soul. That's why I chose this beach as my home, so that I could have peace and quiet to do my work. That's fair enough. Would you like a pomegranate? They are yummy and juicy and tasty. Do not eat it, please, Shelob. I don't care how hungry you are. Shelob, this is a beautiful gift. Thank you. So that's got us to 9 hearts with Elliot. But I don't think it's going to quite get us to 10 yet. So what I'm going to need to do as well today, although I think I might have already got some in the stockpile, is to make complete breakfasts, but I think I already have those. So that's okay. So let's have a quick look at our social and see who we've got that we can do things with. So Emily would have to be our girlfriend to get any more hearts. Harvey and Sebastian are at 10. Sam's at 10. Elliot and Alex are both at 9. Shane's already at 10 as well. Shane is our boyfriend too. Hayley, Abigail, Mario and Leo are all at 8. Pierre is still got 3 hearts to go. So is Penny. Vincent. Awful. We'll work on Vincent in the summer because we can do that. And George. And the dwarf. And Krobus. Ah, we can give him his horseradish now if we have it in our inventory, which we do not. Darn it. Okay, never mind. I keep forgetting about Krobus and the dwarf, but they do sometimes have little cutscenes, so I'm like, well, we need to carry on with that. But we're going to be doing social for quite some time, I think. I'm annoying everybody probably by running past all the berry bushes. But I think it's more important to get the singletons to 10 hearts first. And then I'll work on, like, slowly work on the dwarf and Krobus in my own time sort of thing. Okay, so let's go and just get all the cheese and mayonnaise and things like that in. I've got full inventory again, as usual. Oh, I never put the lobster pots down. Oh no, that's so annoying. Never mind, we can do that later. Right, so I need to get the iridium and iron bars, turn them into sprinklers and put the sprinklers down. And then I need to come back and put on some iron and some refined quartz and fill the cheese and mayonnaise makers up again. So I think I'm going to put them... It's a tough call, really. I'm going to put them down by the Junimo hut here. Finish off this row. I am going to run out of coal as well. So I might need to buy some more wood or something. So I've got 4 plus 6. So I've got 10 more to do here. This is where I never do iridium sprinklers because I'm like, I like my farm too much. Another 2 there. And probably another 5, 10, probably another 12. Probably about another 17 sprinklers to go, I would say, ish. That's a lot of sprinklers. So let's do how much. Let's do don't have any coal. Where did it all go? Did I put it in the box? Yes. 2 of these. And 3 of these. And let's get some wood and start making coal out of it. Because it's cheaper that way. Cheaper to buy the wood off Robin and make the coal. Coal is expensive stuff. I should really go mining for it, honestly, but can't be bothered going down the mines. Some milk and get some eggs. Yeah. Eggs and milk. The problem I'm going around with the mushrooms and stuff in our inventory. It doesn't really help. Okay, so we could sell the cheese and the truffle oil, that would get a few things out of our inventory, and then we can go and maybe put the lobster pots down by the beach while we're waiting for stuff. You know what? We could take Krobus a horseradish while we're going. Why not? Depending on where I put the horseradish. That's a leek. That's not a horseradish. What did I do with my horseradish? No! Where did it go? It's not in there. I must have put it in another chest. How annoying. Come on, Corthok. Let's go. See where we put that stupid horseradish. And this time we will not forget to put the thing by the beach. I could walk directly to the beach, but then I would have to walk back. Horseradish! Okay, let's go. Sewers we go, and beach we go. Spend all our time riding back and forward. I don't even remember what it used to be like before I had the horse. That was so bad. And before I had all the sprinklers, and I was just like, having to water my crops myself every day and harvest them all myself. Because even if the Junos miss a few patches, at least like it's better than nothing. Okay, so lobster pots. We'll just pop them down the beach here. I am told that they will not disappear on me. I hope this is true. And hopefully, if they're put down here, then they should give me nice things like lobsters. Now let's make some bait. Linus gave us some like special bait we could make, but I think we need, yeah, we need slimes and fibre and stuff like that. That's made me a little bit of bait there from the bug meat. Lovely. Right, let's go see Krobus and see if he likes his horseradish. And by then it'll probably be time to go to bed. We have had some lovely cutscenes in this, so I was pretty impressed with that. It's made the episode a little bit long, but I'm sure you guys enjoyed it anyway. Hello, Krobus. I don't know now, I've got to not give him sap. I don't think he would like that. Horseradish. This is an amazing gift. For my people, it is a great honour to receive something like this. Already given Grobus a gift today. Now I want to speak to him. Ah, the sewers are flowing quickly today. It'll get nice and humid in here, just how I like it. Well, I didn't earn any hearts with him. That's a bit weird. Maybe he's really hard to make friends with. Ah, I can buy an Omni Geode off him. That's nice of you, Krobus. I might get something cool out of that. You never know. All these ways around mining for people that don't like to mine. And back to the farm we go. I just need to make sure I sell things before I go to bed as well. Because we've got 4,000 in the bank. That's so bad. I need to make money before the end of the season properly. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to buy seeds for my cranberries and stuff. So I really need to work on that. I spend way too much money. Let's see if there's any mayonnaise and things like that we can sell. Yeah, there's cheese, there's mayonnaise. See if there's anything in here. I could sell the truffle straight up. I could sell the cloth. There's 8 bits of cheese. There's 4 mayonnaises. Some cloth. I don't really want to sell the cloth. We might have more honey to sell soon as well. I'll leave those there for now. We'll make sprinklers out of them in the next time I come in. Should check the honey. No, we don't have any honey. That's a crying shame. I spend way too much time waiting for kegs to do their thing. But I'll definitely have more money when it comes to the summer and the autumn. I'm going to try really hard with that. So 12 mayonnaise, 12 cheese. That should bring something in. Truffle oil should bring something in as well. I might just sell those mushrooms as well. Apricots. Cherries. I can make things out of those that will make more money. No, that's all I'll sell for now. And I think that's just bedtime, isn't it? I think we've done a lot today. I'm going to go and warm myself by the roaring fire. I wish I could do that in real life right now. That'd be so good. And that's time to go to bed. Night, night, Sheila. Let's see how much money we made. 7,000, so that's a bit more respectable bank balance than it was. But it can take, like, nearly sort of 50,000-60,000 to buy all the seeds I'm going to need come the summer. So it might even be more now because I've put more sprinklers down than I had last year. I'm going to make a mint, but it's going to cost me a lot. So anyway, that is the end of the episode for today. I hope you liked it. And if you did, please leave me a like below. And if you would like to see more of Stardew Valley, then please subscribe. And I'll let you know when the new videos are out. I hope to see you next time. But in the meantime, please look after yourselves and keep being awesome.